We will start debug configuration from Cortex-M4, as it is the first one which will run. So I go to this debug icon, click down arrow, go to debug configurations. I double click on the last position, so STM32 Cortex-M CC++ application. It would create automatically the IPCC CM4 debug, so the Cortex-M4 debug configuration of our IPCC project. We go to the debugger tab. We keep the port number as a default value. Then access port would be 0 for Cortex-M4. We will use the connect and the reset. We need to enable serial wire viewer, SWV. And as you can see, it is using the next port number. So 34 and 35 would be used within this Cortex-M4 configuration. Then I would use as well the cross-trigger interface just to have the synchronism between both cores. After this, I press apply. No debug so far. I go to startup, and within this loads image and symbols, I would just add Cortex-M0 plus code debug, and I would not load symbols. It will be done within Cortex-M0 plus debug configuration. I press apply, and let me come back to the debugger tab for a while, and we need to update the core clock of serial wire viewer to be in line with our settings of the system, because within the system we are working with 4 MHz for both cores. And as you remember, serial wire viewer is a synchronous interface which is working with the same clock like core. Just to have proper parameters, I put 4 over here. I click apply and close. The next step is a configuration for Cortex-M0 plus, so I just highlight this project, go to back icon, down arrow, debug configurations. I click again this Cortex-M CC++ application. After this, I can see the CM0 plus debug. I go to debugger tab. I need to update the port number from the default 34 to at least 36, because 34, 35 are already taken by Cortex-M4 and single wire viewer. Okay, so I will not reset once we will, let's say, start this debug session. Serial wire viewer is not available for this core. I would select the cross trigger configuration as well, so I click apply. And within the startup, I need to modify this load image and symbol. So I highlight it and press edit, and I would disable download because it is already done within Cortex-M4 configuration. That's it. So I click apply and close. Now we are ready to start a debug session. Okay, my board is already connected. I connected by wire as well PB3 and my SWO pin within the jumpers area in the middle of the board. This you can verify with the slides. Then I can start a debug session. So I go to the debug icon, down arrow, debug configurations. I select the Cortex-M4 and I click debug. There is a warning that we'll switch to the debug perspective, so with different set of windows. The first point before we will start the code and start the Cortex-M0 Plus as well would be configuration of this serial wire viewer monitoring. So to do this, I go to this search over here. I press serial wire viewer, and we will use this graphical interface, so data trace timeline graph. And we need to configure it, so I click this configure trace icon. I would use the comparator 1. I would monitor our variable for Cortex-M4. This is my data. In case you forget, you can always have a look on the code. So this is my data. We'll put the read-write access and generate data value plus program counter. And the core clock is 4 MHz, which is okay. And we need to press OK. Now I can start tracings by pressing this icon. And now if I would start the code execution, I can see that the data is already taken from this global variable, and we are expecting to have a square wave at the beginning, and we can see that it's really in line with our expectations. We can zoom it out to have a better look. Okay, so now as our code is working, I can start Cortex-M0 Plus as well. In fact, this application Cortex-M0 Plus is already started, because within this debug configuration we already loaded Cortex-M0 Plus content as well. What is not loaded are, let's say, the symbols for the debug session. Those we can do, we can load using again this back icon, down arrow, debug configurations, and Cortex-M0 Plus debug. Now we are loading the symbols, and we'll have both cores running. Okay, this one is suspended, so I'd run it. And if I go to single wire viewer, nothing is changed. But if I would press the button related to Cortex-M0 M0 Plus, this is either button 1 or 3. So the first or third one, we can see that the shape is changed, because the shared buffer has been updated with the signed buffer, and then within Cortex-M4 core, this shared buffer has been copied to user buffer. So within user buffer, right now we've got a sinusoidal shape, which we can see on the screen. If I would zoom it out, I can see that we've got the sine wave instead of the square wave. This is not symmetrical, as you can see. This is due to the fact that we are performing the copying of the data from the buffer to the local variable within the main while one loop in the loop, and then after this there are more parts of the code, and sometimes this code takes a bit more time, and during this time there is a display of last content of the global variable, not updated one. If I would press right now the button related to Cortex-M4, so the middle one, B2, we will have the switch, an update of user button from the sine wave to the square wave. So this is the after the reset configuration. If I would press button 1, P1, so PA0 connected to Cortex-M0 Plus, I can see again that there is a, let's say, copy of sine buffer to the shared buffer, and then within Cortex-M4 shared buffer is copied to user buffer, and this content of this buffer we can see one by one on the screen. So application is working as expected, and we can finish here. So I would terminate the debug session for both cores. Thank you for watching this video.